We start with PG&E trying to dig its way out of wildfire trouble. This week, the utility admitted its equipment may have sparked the massive Dixie fire. Now a proposal to bury miles of power lines across the state. KPIX5's Wilson Walker is live in Santa Rosa with more on this ambitious plan and, of course, the cost. Wilson?
You use the word ambitious. They used the word ambitious. They called it one of the largest infrastructure projects in the state's history, the country's history. They sort of waxed poetic about this grand plan. But yeah, who is going to pay for this?
We do these things not because they're easy, but because they're hard. Because the challenge is one that we are willing to accept.
Quoting directly from President John F. Kennedy's famous moonshot speech, the CEO of PG&E announced plans to bury 10,000 miles of power line in California, something a lot of people have long asked for.
I mean, how many blackouts can you have? How many fires can we have? We live right at the base of that hill over there that was burned last year.
Now, added safety, of course, will come with a price.
I mean, it's like dropping a bomb on ratepayers in terms of the impact of the cost.
Ratepayer advocates say they were blindsided by today's announcement. Just last week, PG&E was only planning on burying about 250 miles of line.
The cost of undergrounding for 10,000 miles would be about $40 billion. This is on top of the $19 billion that PG&E is already asking for in rate increases over the next 4 years.
The utility says its current undergrounding efforts are giving them an education on how to do this more efficiently.
We found synergies with our natural gas work as well and with telecom providers to do joint trenching that lowers the cost. It also reduces the environmental impact.
People we spoke with today are happy to hear about the improvements.
I think that they've had the means to correct the problem and they haven't. So I'm very pleased to hear that they are now taking action.
Cost will be the ultimate question. PG&E has not said how this might affect customers' bills. Advocates are hoping the PUC will keep costs from spiraling out of control.
They have to hold PG&E accountable to reducing wildfire risk without making electricity so expensive that only the wealthy can afford it. That's what the problem is right now.
You know, one of the big questions is cost. Obviously, that is getting weighed against risk. Liz, as you mentioned, they invoked the Dixie Fire and that being caused by a tree against lines. I'm standing here on the northern edge of Santa Rosa where the Tubbs Fire blew in. We all know the story behind that fire. I talked to people up here and they all right offhand said, yeah, we're excited to hear that. And then the very next thought is, who is going to pay for this? This will be a long discussion between PG&E and the PUC, and it will affect your bill. We're live up here in Santa Rosa. Wilson Walker, KPIX5.
Yeah, that money's got to come from somewhere. Thank you, Wilson. We brought you live coverage of PG&E's announcement on CBSN Bay Area. You can download the KPIX5 News app and tune in or head to KPIX.com.